What is up, guys? Welcome back to another MMA breakdown. If you have not seen the full fights, don't watch the video. Click the very, very first link in the description box, and it'll take you to where you can watch the fights on MMAcore.com. They always post the fights. Maybe it's HD, maybe it's a standard definition, but you will get to see the fights. I don't want to ruin the fights for you, but you could probably watch most of the fights there. But as always, if you're already seeing the fights, you already know what's going to happen, you just want my opinion on the fights, then stay tuned. After the break, we'll be right back with the MMA breakdown of UFC 131. Dude, that last UFC fight with Max Holloway versus Brian Ortega was sick. It was like just back and forth, like brutality at its finest. The doctor stopped in and said, "Nah, the fight's not gonna continue," because I was like this, like that, and it was all black and blue around. That dude has heart. Max Holloway reminds me of Nate and Nick Diaz. Why do I say that? Because they come forward with a high volume of striking, like very high. But if you guys haven't seen the fight, there's a link down there to go watch it. Woo! That was like, I don't know if I was expecting it to be that kind of fight, but Max Holloway improved his takedown defense. He so reminds me of the Diaz brothers with all those strikes that he was landing. He was just like, boom, boom. They're like pitter-patter punches, but they're meant to hurt you and just fluster you by throwing not one punch at a time, but body shots. And that is the way to win fights, is not throwing every strike at once, because when you throw every strike at once towards your opponent, if you don't land them all the time, you're gassing yourself out because you're throwing more heavy strikes. That's why Conor McGregor, he passes out quickly because he's throwing everything into his punches instead of just like pitter-patter. Pitter-patter is going like 20%, but when you're landing like 100%, like 70% of your strikes, you're throwing like 200-300 strikes during the fight. And when you're a power puncher, you might be throwing maybe 30 punches, and if you can, and you're landing some of them and your opponent's not getting knocked out, it really drains the gas tank. And you've seen that in the later rounds, that Brian Ortega's gas tank like this, from being good to being not good. But the fight itself was pretty phenomenal. It was one of the best fights ever. It was one of the best 145 fights I've ever seen. Brian Ortega has heart. Max Holloway proved that he is one of the best 145-pound fighters with 13 consecutive wins. That's crazy. Crazy. Crazy for feelings, so blue. And then you had Valentina Shevchenko. Yep. Beat Joanna basically convincingly. Joanna's not known as a well-rounded MMA fighter. She's like Conor McGregor. She could beat your ass on the feet, but she ain't beating your ass on the ground. And at 125, she does look better. Valentina's going from 135, I think, down to 125. And she looked like a beast. She looked on point. She was just landing a lot of strikes. And this is, I think, Joanna's third loss in a row. I'm not sure if she had a fight before this, or if the last two fights were against Rose Namajunas. but she did lose tonight. So she is, if I'm not mistaken, either she's 1-3 in her last four fights, or she's 0-3 in her last three fights. But whatever, the point is, she did lose the fight. Basically, convincingly, she got taken down. And if you guys didn't know, Valentina beat her three times in Muay Thai for titles, for championships, and she also beat her in MMA, so she's 0-4 against Valentina Shevchenko. And Shevchenko is a beast. She's just one of those dudes that, one of those chicks that is everly improving. She is very well-rounded. It's like they said on the broadcast that she reminds them of George St. Pierre. If she wants to go train Muay Thai, she goes to the Muay Thai camp. She wants to train wrestling, she goes to the best wrestling camp in the world. And that's how you're going to improve yourself, by training at the best training facility with the top athletes in that field. So you want to get better at jiu-jitsu? You train with the best, baddest jiu-jitsu players like Eddie Bravo. You want to go wrestle? You train with DC, Khabib, or George St. Pierre. You want to train kickboxing? You go and train with somebody like Cowboy Donald Cerrone, or somebody like a Conor McGregor, because those guys are badass. Just crazy. You want to learn Wing Chun? You go train with Tony El Kikui Ferguson. But overall, I did buy the pay-per-view for $40. I didn't buy the HD version. Why? Because I'm buying it on UFC.tv. So I don't need HD. But overall, I'll say the damn pay-per-view was phenomenal from top to bottom. The co-main event and the main event were the best two fights on the card. And I'm always saying to myself, I should be betting on these fucking fights, because I would be making some damn cash and making some damn money. But overall, I'm just so pumped for this fight card. I was so pumped. Max Holloway did what he did. And they said Brian Ortega, the reasoning they stopped the fight was not because his eye was swelled shut like this. It's because he didn't answer the doctor. His coaches were saying, trying to convince the doctor to keep letting him fight. But I think he was already beaten and hurt, and the doctor was just like, we basically seen enough, because his eye was like this. Sometimes it is a smart idea, even if you have the heart, to come back out there for that fifth round or that fourth round or that second round, just to say, hey, Max Holloway was a better man tonight. Max was just a better guy. We'll see each other down the road. But like I said, that was a badass fight, man. It kind of went the way I thought it would be going. I didn't think it would go as long, but like, it was funny because Max Holloway told Joe Rogan when the round started, this is the round that I'm finishing the fight, is the fourth round. And he finished the fight in the fourth round. He put on the pressure, he put on the cardio tank, and he just came forward, pressuring and pressuring and pressuring. But, like I said, one hell of a fucking fight, man. This was one of the craziest cards. They hyped it up. I think it was good for Max Holloway not to fight the first time they were supposed to fight, because it actually got those two guys to get better as skill set. And Max Holloway, I think, just got way better. And I think his long reach played into the fight. And I'll say one last thing. I think, like Daniel Cormier said in one of his fights, there's different levels to this. There's Brian Ortega level, and then there's Conor McGregor level, and then there's Max Holloway level. And Max Holloway level is, here's Brian Ortega like just beating every guy, like just beating them. And Max Howell is up here. It's like John Jones just beating everybody. DC beating everybody, but DC can't beat John Jones, so DC's here. John Jones is always here. It's the same thing with Valentina Shevchenko. She's here. Joanna's here. Joanna will beat 99% of the women, but she just can't beat her. So, as always, guys, remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. Like I said, remember to click the links in the description box. It'll take you where you can actually watch the fight. My name is Trevor, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.